Good morning, everyone. I'd like to make a presentation, which the topic I choose is to focus on the Cossack appearance of the military of this period that is called either Ukrainian Revolution or the Civil War or the Wars of Ukrainian Independence in 1917-1921. In this period, some components of military dress were supposed to emphasize the Ukrainian national character of the armies, of the military, of the Ukrainian People's Republic or Ukrainian National Republic and the Ukrainian state. Much research has been devoted to the uniforms of the Ukrainian armies, however, the scholars consider the so-called Cossack elements of military clothing as expressing real national traditions. But in my opinion, this understanding is erroneous because there is a misperception of such items of clothing as, for example, sheepskin fur hat with a hanging top. I don't know if this works. You see the hat. The shariwari trousers, white trousers, and the jupan with this fabric belt. There's a misperception that these items of clothing are historical and characteristic of the Cossacks of 17-18 centuries, but they were quite recent folk clothing, and even modern, the late 19th, early 20th centuries ideas about Cossack clothing. So when we speak about Cossack tradition, this could mean either the use of clothing items from the so-called Cossack times to the 20th century, or the transmission of information about clothing about them to the 20th century, or at least the reproduction of this clothing of 17-18 centuries in the 20th century. But as we shall see below, none of these three options really took place. In the case of the so-called Cossack elements or components of military clothing of the Ukrainian armed formations of 1917-1921, we are more likely to deal with the invented tradition and the Cossack myth that was the basis of these traditions for the state and military construction. The same reasons, for example, led to use of the ancient ranks in 20th century armed forces, like Cossack was the first rank, like Koshovoy Ataman, Khurumji, Bunchuzhny, and so on. Like the names of the units that were used in this time, Kurinj, Sotnya, Kish, that resembled the Cossack times, and the names, like the part, name parts and compounds of words such as Zaporizhia, Cossack, Haidamaki, and the names of warlords of the early modern times, like Bogdan Khmelnytsky Regiment, for example, or Horse, Haidamaki Kost, Khordienko Regiment, and so on. However, the Cossack myth was particularly striking in the military clothing of this period, of the Ukrainian armed formations in 1917-1921. Already prior to the First World War, Ukrainian paramilitary organizations in Galicia began to establish uniforms. For example, a network of Ukrainian siege organizations, the very name of which resembles the Zaporizhia siege, it had a special uniform which included, light gray knee-length broadcloth jupan, white pants, the hat with a soon black hanging top, and the shirt only embroidered. as one of the contributors of this organization, one of the co-founders, Roman Dashkevich, noted that such uniforms were not practical, but at the same time such men liked it because it resembled the Cossack era. Also in the First World War, the Legion of Ukrainian Siege Riflemen had uniforms which also had this cap, this so-called Mazepinka cap on the right below, and it had this characteristic V-shaped section of valves in front, and the similar cut can be seen on Hetman Mazepa. This is a painting made in 1909 by Osip Kurilas, and this painting probably inspired the author of this Mazepinka cap, Dmytro Katamai. Beside the Legion of Ukrainian Siege Riflemen, the Central Powers, Germany and Austria-Hungary, their command at the end of the First World War decided to create troops from the Ukrainian prisoners of war. For example, in January 1917, prisoners of war in Vetslar camp received their own blue uniform, which included Shorovara trousers, blue jupan, and this later, when these formations were transferred to Ukraine in 1918, the first Ukrainian division was formed, and it was uniformed with chumara or jupan coat, blue shorovara trousers, gray sheepskin hats with a blue hanging top, like on this colorized photograph on the right. According to the memoirs of the division commander Viktor Zelinsky, this uniform appeared because of his own desire to have national blue broadcloth jupans. And due to the jupans of blue color, they were called blue jupan, синие жупанники, the blue division. Well, later when it was transferred to Ukraine, it's left in the memoirs of the Ukrainian political and military figures, the image of slender military figures on beautiful assumed jupans, and also this image of blue jupans, of синие жупанники, was used in Soviet propaganda, as we can see on the left in Boris Yefimov caricature in 1918, which shows this Ukrainian like Asian horde faces, and this characteristic blue jupans and hat with a hanging top. And also the image from 1973 Soviet movie The Old Fortress, Stara Krepost. In the camps in Austria-Hungary, where the first Cossack Rifle Division was formed, they used also the so-called Cossack uniform. They received gray, or more precisely, Feldgrau uniforms, which included the chumara or jupan coat, and first they had the similar hats with hanging tops present on the image on the left, and this is from the Heeresgeschichte Museum in Vienna, but later it was abandoned in favor of a round cap on the right. But the Cossack myth was particularly strong with the closing of the Ukrainian military self-organized formations. The desire for an external demonstration of this national identity of Ukrainians in 1917 led to wear these hats with hanging tops, the embroidered shirts, the forelocks, the so-called herring forelocks, or soledads. For example, the tops of the usual Russian papakha hat had sewn these hanging tops, like on the image left and central, this caricature of Simon Petlura himself, made by Boris Yefimov in 1918. He was an eyewitness. This hanging tops gave the name for even two units of the Haidamaka Kish of Sloboda, Ukraine, laid by Simon Petlura, the red and black hydromaki. Well, they used red and black hanging tops on their heads. Also in the spring of 1918, the fashion of wearing black hats with colored tops spread to the Zaporizhia division, or detached Zaporizhia division. Also, at the beginning of the revolution in 1917, the Cherkessian chokha, this garment on the left, was also used as a component of this invented tradition. It was a uniform of the Cossack-Cuban host, but according to Cuban native Vasil Prokhoda, there was only a name left from the indigenous Cuban Cossacks with the traditions and customs of the former Zaporozhians, and the material culture changed completely. Nevertheless, the Dnieper Ukrainians considered the Cuban Cossacks as the direct descendants of the Zaporozhian Cossacks, and the Cherkessian chokha became a distinctive Cossack feature. And according to Nikifor Abramenko, who left his memoirs, the very presence of him in this Cherkessian chokha in one of the Kharkov restaurants, it caused the remark of one of the Russian officers that here comes the Cherkessian chokhol. Well, the hetman of Ukraine, Pavlo Skoropadsky himself, also wear this Cherkessian chokha. In numerous photographs, he visited Berlin, visited Kaiser Wilhelm, wearing this Cherkessian chokha. And some of the Ukrainian military formations kept their Cossack clothing items even after a series of orders that regulated the uniforms of the Ukrainian armies. For example, there was a quite unusual case of the so-called Black Zaporozhians. On the left, the Black Zaporozhian regiment had also Cherkessian chokhas, black jupans, white trousers under them, and even there was a such unique, curious case presented in the memoirs of Avramenko mentioned above, that when they did not have, for example, black jupans, they could use a white suit, a white tie suit, frock, black of black color. And also the commander of the Galician army who saw these black Zaporozhians, Mikhail Marinovich Pavlenko, he described the impressions that were gained from the observation of their participation in the battle. It was a true departure of the Falcons, Cossacks in all black with long hat tops flying in the air, caused a stir among the enemy. And another witness, Lev Shonkovsky, he suggested that this flying of the head tops was possibly taken over by their ancestors from the steppe peoples. So it was really this invented tradition. And it is interesting to know that one of the one anonymous author of the Viktor Dyshenko obituary mentioned that his brother Petro Dyshenko was the commander of the Black Zaporozhians. He rather reminded him not the old Zaporozhians, but the Pandua Corps commander in the times of Maria Theresa, Franz von der Trenk. On the left, he wrote that Trenk and his regiment wore clothes and hats similar to the Black Zaporozhians, which differed only by the red head tops which Panduas had, while the Black Zaporozhians had black ones. Also a vivid description of another self-organized unit, the so-called Zaporizhia siege led by Ataman Boshko, is submitted by Mykola Arkas Jr. This is the image of Ataman Boshko, and he described his impression like this. Ataman Boshko was dressed in a Cherkessian chokha with a hood thrown over his shoulders. On his head lay the sheepskin papaha hat with an enormous crimson hanging top. Tall yellow skin boots complemented his clothing. The Kurenyi Ataman, another person, wore a long green jupan, a red kuntush, and golden belt that hung to the knees on both sides, the red shalwari tucked in yellow boots. The hat had a green top with a silver tassel, which apparently had been trimmed into a landlord's lodging drape before. All the troops that had rallied around the superiors were dressed so sharply that they twinkled in our eyes. Sotnik Tobolevich, who was also present at, in this meeting, immediately stated that a good half of this bouquet was dressed in the requisites of the troop of his father, Mykola Karpovich Sadovsky, the famous Ukrainian playwright, theatrical figure. And he said that it was on these props a month ago that the Bushko Freeman made a daring raid in order to dress properly. But no matter how the Cossack components of military clothing indicated the nationality of the soldiers, the state and the military command needed to introduce the uniform for the entire army. And so in the first order by the Ukrainian People's Republic Minister of Defense concerning uniforms in April 18, 1918, there were the uniforms of English pattern, galifet trousers, English pattern jacket were introduced, and none of this resembled Cossack traditions except for the hat, the gray with a hanging top in an army branch color. And the latter element, apparently, it was it also only confirmed the widespread unauthorized use of these hats with hanging tops, which has grown from the national tradition, so-called national tradition, to a real tradition of using in the Ukrainian army units. Then, after the hetman's coup, the uniforms of his convoy guard and army were introduced. And the convoy uniform had a strongly marked Cossack appearance. This jupa decorated with cords, shalwari trousers, also a hat, the so-called Mazepinka hat, which present on Hetman himself, Hetman Skoropadsky. It differed from the Mazepinka hat that was in Galicia. Then, in January 1919, the new uniform was introduced. The combat dress included a grey cap with a hanging top, grey broadcloth jupan based on the grey division pattern, like this in the Feldgrau color, like mentioned above. Ceremonial dress included black sheepskin hat with fabric insert, with white plume, blue historical jupan, Cossack shalwari, all red. Although there is no no evidence at all of using these uniforms. The subsequent reformation of the army uniforms in April 1919 introduced also, again, English pattern caps and jackets instead of Cossack ones. The only mention of the traditions was the overcoat of the Chumarka cut, is from the order, from the painting in the order. But it was replaced by the usual one on the following order in June 30, 1919. On August 25, 1919, the new order of the UNR War Minister Petriv, Saul Petriv, who was an admirer of tops and clauses of registered Cossacks, he himself introduced for his Kost-Hordienko regiment introduced a slightly upgraded clauses of the registered Cossack of the late 17th and 18th centuries, like he mentioned in his memoirs. But we can be sure that no one in this regiment, and Saul Petriv himself, did not conduct any studies on the clothing of Ukrainian Cossacks. This order of August 1919, it legalized the Mazepinka hats with short tops. And as stated in the preamble of this order, it was done in honor to our former glorious Zaporizhia Haidamaki army, our ancestors and grandfathers, who in the 17th century fought for independence of their homeland in honor of the unforgettable traditions of those Haidamaki. Also, the Mazepinka cap of the Ukrainian siege riflemen was used in the Western Ukrainian People's Republic, the Galician army, but it was the only element that resembled the Cossack era, and it was used as the only headdress of the Galician army from April to August 1919, and then it was abandoned completely. In 1912, the Cossack traditions fell prey to practicality and modernity. The uniform orders did not contain any mention of the Cossack elements, Cossack components. However, there was the only Mazepinka hats, sheepskin hats with hanging tops and this V-shaped cut in front, they were left because not because of the Cossack tradition, but because of the tradition that that existed in this Ukrainian armies. For example, in Black Zaporozhian regiment, they wore these hats from 1917-1918. Then, in 1920, when a new order concerning the uniforms was issued, they used this Mazepinka pattern because they had a tradition of wearing them, not because of the Cossack times. But again, in the internment, in the emigre period, on the photographs presented below from the right, the Ukrainian officers also posed for photographs in the so-called old Cossack pattern uniforms, whether it was Zhuban or Mazepinka hat. So, concluding, although the Cossack components were popular mainly in self-organized military units with their own ideas about national traditions and among the so-called free Cossacks, nevertheless, historical Zhupans and the so-called Cossack Sharavari were also included in official army orders concerning Ukrainian state and Ukrainian People's Republic uniforms. During the revolution of 1917-1921, such major components of Cossack clothing as hats with hanging tops, Zhupans, white trousers and fabric belts evolved. They were used. At the same time, these things were not used by the Cossacks in 17 and most parts of the 18th centuries. Therefore, during the Ukrainian Revolution, the soldiers recreated in clothing only their own ideas about the Cossacks, not the real Cossack clothing. So we can call them Zhuda-Cossack things, Zhuda-Cossack components, and they intended to express only the belonging to Ukrainian army. They were used to legitimize the existence of the Ukrainian modern nation and to, we can say, to vaccinate these traditions by extending these stylizations of ancient wardrobe items among soldiers and by securing for the modern soldiers of 20th century this image of the Cossack, this image of the fighters for the Ukrainian nation. Thank you very much.